Why haven't you guys subscribed yet?
Alright, so today we came to the 𝐒𝐨𝐜𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢𝐢 eight of us, seven of us today. Too bad one of us couldn't come down, but you know, he never comes out. He's just one of those guys. Originally, we wanted to go somewhere else, but you know, no seating inside and it was raining, so we couldn't go there. All right, I had the veggie English breakfast. So it was like veggie sausages, beans, egg, toast, you know, and all that. They ask you like how you want your egg. The food was quite bland. I'd add like some salt and pepper onto it just to give it a bit more flavor. Interior looks good. I give that 4 or 5. Very nice. The only thing was the table was a bit dirty when we sat down, so I had to call them up to come and clean it. But you know, they were all nice about it. Price wise, so I paid about £9 for the whole thing, which I would say is decent. You know, you get a like full breakfast, it fills you up. I couldn't finish all of it. But yeah, overall decent experience. They close early, as with most cafes do. They close at 4. So if you want to come here, come down early. If you're older, you'll love this place. Younger, maybe not so much. Overall, I'd give this shop like a 3 out of 5. They could have wiped the tables before he came down. I think they slipped up on that one. Otherwise, I would have given like a 3.5. But if you live in the area, or you're a bit older, then you know, pop by.
I had the English breakfast, you know, because we're in England, we had to represent the country. They had everything that English breakfast would have. Overall, it was nice, but it was kind of basic. It wasn't great, but you know, it's fine. It was edible. The service was nice. The lady was attentive. She helped us out when she took our order, but she was closing quite early, so we had to leave. I kind of made her have to wait a little longer because I gave her a £50 note and I shouldn't have. Sorry. I rated the food like 3.5 out of 5 because I didn't know the food wasn't terrible, but it wasn't amazing either. Price was, the interior was good. It was really nice. It looked like a place for like older people. I give the overall rating like 3.5 out of 5 because for its demographic, it does its purpose and it does what it's meant to do, but I prefer more of a upbeat type of place.
So today we went to 𝐒𝐨𝐜𝐢𝐢 Caffe. I had the like halloumi, tomatoes, sourdough bread. First thing I know is the halloumi is very salty, kind of. But overall, it did taste nice. Like there was a nice combination, the avocado, the tomato and the egg. Sourdough bread wasn't very sour, you know, a bit weird. Yeah, overall, I'd say 2.5 out of 5. Like, decent breakfast, but not very well with the taste factor. Service standard, you know, came in, took order, left. Price was pretty decent, you know, had a full breakfast, lots of options, but only, what, £8? Pretty good for its price. Tastes not too good, but, you know, does the job. So yeah, 2.5.
I came late because I got lost.
We went to 𝐒𝐨𝐜𝐢𝐢 Caffe in Stanmore. I had a brunch, mashed avocado on sourbread toast with poached eggs and extra smoked salmon. I also had a nutty chocolate coffee and I did go there hungry. So maybe that's why, but I found it really delicious. It was really, really good. It looked gorgeous as well. The place looked amazing, really cozy and perfect for a rainy day like this one. You can clearly see that we were the youngest group there, but I can see why. We didn't wait too much for the food, but the lady who served us felt like she didn't really like us filming, which is fair enough, I guess. Probably creeped out by Mr. Munch. Again, fair enough. But we had fun. They didn't complain about us being too loud or something like that. And overall, I had a great time there. Out of 5, I would give it a 4. 4 out of 5, yeah.
I had poached eggs with avocado on sourdough bread. Bit skeptical, not a big fan of avocado, but it was tasty, very tasty. Lots of flavor in the avocado, which was very surprising. I also had a freshly made banana and strawberry smoothie. Delicious, very fresh, very definitely worth it for a one-time thing, but that's all I had, and that came up to nearly £12. That is quite expensive just for some eggs on toast and some fruit, really. Inside was nice. It does shut early, so towards the end, I did arrive a bit late and I did feel a little bit rushed. They did give us a little pre-mint chocolate when we paid, and that was nice. Overall, I think I'd give it a 4. I think other people may not agree on a 4, but it was delicious. Price not great, could have been better. Not bad for a one-time trip.
All right, guys, it's been a long day. Pretty tired, it's night now. Some hooligans in the back, you know, forget them. Anyway, I'm going home.
Hi boss, how's it going?
How's it going, man? Hey, let's go. Whoa, whoa, hey, hey, hey! I don't pay you for this. All right, fucking here.
Beep, beep,
let's go. All right, that's it, that's it. Hey, 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 hey!
It's not reference. It's not the guy with the goggles. It's Mr. Munch.
Mr. Munch.
Mr. Munch. Why you want to edit that in? Oh my. Right, well, redundant.
Lol.
Oh. Get him out of the boom.
Hello.
Say Charles O'Keefe last month.
Charles life's now.
Charles O'Keefe life now.
Mr. O'Keefe's life matters.
Fuck you.
Charles is dad. Charles O'Keefe's life matters. Not Charles O'Keefe.